I honestly haven't heard a whole lot of either one of them.
That is going to be a kill on Immersion, potentially.
Crit gets a little bit low. Immersion finally is going to take out from S4, running him down, but now he's going to be shackled up, and Hawk gets his opportunity to start laying up those Fury Swipes. Don't let him get the Rot tonight. They do not.
I might even go for more here as...
Yeah, thinking about it, does manage to get the Hex.
1 second.
1 second for the Shackles, and Crit has no way to stop this, so he's just going to have to watch his captain die. 2-for-1 exchange here in the top lane. Pushing up this bottom lane, and they know somebody's got to bite, somebody's got to push this out. But Evil Geniuses do have a lot of heroes behind Arteezy. Can they save him in time, though? They cannot. The silence doesn't come out fast enough. The Rolling Thunder on through. They're going to have to make this trade-off worth it for them. This Meteor is going to be dropped here. FNG easily gets cleaned up. They're trying to keep Smail alive, vacuum him back into the Serpent Wards, but he's still not dead. In fact, he's going to stay alive long enough that Afo has to give up as he was running low on mana, has to jump himself away. Hook! Nice grab there from S4. That's going to be the Ursa who gets picked off as well. Yes, they do. Real quick, I cannot overextend myself right now. And instead, it's going to be Immersion who's caught. S4, okay, vacuum into three with the wall with the Serpent Wards as well. Crit's going to try and jump his way out of this one with Shield Crash and roll away. But they're leaving behind Samael, who's Ghost Scepter'd up. He's keeping himself alive against the Ursa for now, but eventually will run out.
There
S4
go.
Tried to go for the save with the hook, but now he's going to be run down by the Ursa. And Samael, or excuse me, Fly is potentially in trouble as Afo zips on top of him. That is what we're talking about. The catch, the mobility that they have. Even with Serpent Wards doing so much damage, nice pull in from the hook. But this is an opportunity for Afo trying to go for the back line with a beautiful vacuum into wall situation here where Fly is in big trouble. Crit is trying to help out with a buyback, though, coming up from Samael. They want to be able to catch these heroes, punish them with this buyback, get as many kills as possible. FNG barely managed to get away with the teleport ahead of the dismember. It's going to be Darkseer who's in trouble right now as he's completely lucky shot it up, slowed down enough. He won't be able to get the surge away, which he gave to the Ursa to get out. Fortunately, no critical kills for EG on the side of Gambit. In fact, oh, maybe I spoke too soon, though. Afo trying to commit to go for the kill onto Crit here.
Crit's
might be able to get
dead.
It, but he's going to die in exchange for that. That. Surely that wasn't worth
enough time here.
It's happening so quickly, and look at Crit. He's going to pop the Rolling Thunder as soon as Roshan's about to die. He's just going to bounce around, making sure that the Storm Spirit can't jump in and find anything. Now he's going to roll on out, intercept some of the Gambit heroes. You do manage to get a good vacuum wall with the Serpent Wards out as well. They're trying to finish off Samael, but again, that Ghost Scepter delaying so much. The Exorcism is allowing Samael to be able to get away here. Afo, a little bit low on mana. Arteezy with his full BKB activated just goes for the kill into the Nyx Assassin. That's a double kill for him. If he wants to, he can go for the Shrine area, but instead he's going to go for Afo, who's going to be forced to use more of his mana just to be able to run away from Arteezy right now, completely negating the opportunity.
Oh! Oh!
He had mana too!
Mama me!
Present that big of a threat quite yet.
The Sheevas? Oh, self-fuels. Can S4 actually get the Dismember off of the Abyssal Blade? They aren't going to be able to lock down this Storm Spirit. No buyback from him as the Ursa comes
over.
Up and is finally up. There is no fight really to be had unless they get a really good vacuum wall. The Rolling Thunder bouncing around here trying to slow down this Ursa, and it does. Ursa's just not able to finish up Arteezy like he had planned. The Satanic kills Arteezy back up the full, and Evil Geniuses. Just going to keep running forward here and go straight for Samael. They have him with the Orchid. Yule Sceptered up, and Immersion's going to be able to drop the Avalanche on top of that with the Sonic Wave, and there goes Samael. He's already dead. A Rolling Thunder on through is going to be really well set up. He's going to be able to land on top of multiple heroes, but S4 is already dead, and that means there's no more damage, no more team fight to follow up that big control from Crit. And Gambit can look for that kill as well, as now he's going to be Orchided up. That comes off cooldown. See if they can burst him down. The Orchid and the toss in from the Bears. That's going to be good enough. Oh, he didn't?
Yeah. Oh.
Oh, big golem going to be laid out here with Afo having a double damage rune. This is looking pretty good for themselves. Crit does manage to roll in and finish off the Tiny. Actually hit some backline heroes as well. Afo is going to be hit again as Crit continues to control them up. And long as Arteezy can deal out the damage, he kills the support. But Afo is able to blink himself away. A 2-for-1 exchange with Samael just barely living. Oh, no. Now they've got a duel with an Orchid on top of that. Arteezy's dropping fast and he will fall. Winner for Afterlife.
Also, that Sumail's like, it goes both ways. Like, they're too far, but also Sumail's too far ahead of them.
Yeah.
As they're gonna pop.
Oh, they're gonna drop the rock here, turn and fight. They're gonna be able to get a duel onto the back line. Can they blow up this Brewmaster in time? They're losing all the damage because of Crit's Rolling Thunder is controlling up the Queen of Pain, who had that double damage rune. The toss over is gonna be able to do a lot of damage with the help of the bear. Evil Geniuses, though, now they've got two dead, no Sonic Wave. They know the Gambit is running out of spells here. They're gonna try and chase down whoever they can, and Afo just uses Blink. 2 seconds out for the Blink. Toss over from Immersion. Is that enough time? It's not. He ends up burned out from the Radiance, and now Immersion will get caught by Samael as well. Evil Geniuses.
He needed to
finally win a fight. and that is now trouble as the Lone Druid Bear is going to die. Afo.
He's going to resummon it, and the rock over the top.
The rock over the top. Samael dropping low. They might be able to burst him down with a BKB activated Sonic Wave, and that is enough. 60 seconds down. Now they manage to get the Avalanche onto Crit, unable to finish off his Rolling Thunder, but now the Queen of Pain is dead. Here comes a big jump in for the duel, but there's no follow-up as again, the Rolling Thunder stopping all the damage as the Legion Commander jumps in. A triple kill for Arteezy will finish.